in the arms of an angel. Please, please donate to a hungry drifter that you know who crashed his car in these sad times. I need your funds to help me go drifting again. Help me fix my car, please. So yeah, I wrecked the Altezza. I was at Villain Sportsland. I put the car into the wall much harder than I ever have before. I've been to Villains many times and hit the right rear here on the wall many times. Wrecked many taillights, but never like this. I mean, I was really off the line. I was probably like 3 feet off the line and way too deep into the wall. You can see the rear wheel hit the wall, so that tells you how far off I was. That brought the front around, as it tends to do, so the front wheel hit. It's kind of the end of an era. I haven't wrecked a car like this badly in a long time. I'm well aware of that being a possibility every single time you go out, you know, and I tell other people that all the time, and I tell passengers that, and I don't really have to tell myself that. I fully know it through and through that, like, every time, every single lap that you go out there, like, the whole car could go away, you know? And, you know, in my case, I'm sort of lucky, or, you know, whatever, like, the radiator's fine, you know, the engine is fine, the oil pan's fine, the transmission's fine, like, all the suspension arms are fine. It's not a total loss. But I was okay with something sort of happening to this car. Still doesn't mean I wanted it to happen. The hit did have a fair amount of energy and did go back pretty far into the car. Both of the towers are over. One of them's over a bit more than the other, it looks like. So it's going to be a pretty penny to fix it. And I just don't know if it makes sense. I could buy an entire IS300 complete running car for the same amount that it would cost me to fix this. And then I would have bumpers, doors, an entire new car, and have a NA2J block and a full engine. But in my heart, I don't really want to do that anyway. This chassis was always just a tool for me to go drifting. And I did a lot of that with this car. I probably did more drifting in this car than any other car I've ever had. I honestly probably did more drifting in this car than all of my other cars combined. Yeah, you know, I got to drive the Ridge last year with this car. I've driven Affinity Circuit in Medford. I got to redrive Western Speedway before it closed a couple of times with this car. Drove Horse Thief Mile, Range, Adams, Muscle Man, driven Evergreen, yeah, Penticton, a fair few tracks. I've probably driven more tracks in this car than all the other cars combined as well. I do think you have to love your drift car a bit though, you know? Like, if you're gonna put that much time and energy into making it look nice and making it function well and create the vision that you had in your head, and then, you know, I think you have to love it a bit because it's a ton of work. It's a ton of work and a ton of money, so you sure as hell better love your car. And definitely hurts when you can't use it anymore. Yeah, when I first got it, it was supposed to just be a cheap engine and transmission, the Beams motor, 3SGE, and the J160 6-speed for a 72 Corolla wagon I had. That was always the plan. It was cheaper for me to get the whole car from Japan than it was for me to get the motor and transmission off eBay. But then I got it and I started to like it. You know, it had power windows. It had like a good stereo. It had power doors. It was decently peppy. It was quiet. It was reliable, which my Corolla at the time wasn't so reliable. So it was sort of all these things that my Corolla wasn't. And then I ended up deciding just to stick with it. When it had the 3S, I had Air Ride on it. It had all the Serialnine arms. We developed all the arms on this car, the subframe bushings, the diff bushings, toe, traction, rear, lower, front, upper. So I had all those arms on this car with Air Ride and short knuckles, so it air out super, super low, like right on the rocker. And then I would drive it not so much higher than that. Eventually the 3S had super low compression in one cylinder. The car came apart once the engine was gone. It sat in the corner of the shop. Eventually the parts got pillaged. There was no motor, and then it sat around for 2 or 3 years like that. Then I think it was 2019, Gerard and I decided we're gonna go drive Final Bout. Final Bout Gallery was that event. It was in Chicago. There's a Chicago Aspect, and then there's the US Air actual event. So at the time I was like trying to buy a car. I was gonna buy a 110, or I was gonna buy a Crown, or this, that, or the other. Time was sort of getting short. And it was like, well, why don't I just buy a one JZ and put it in the car that's already here that we already have? So it kind of made more sense, being that the car was from North America. If I needed headlights or taillights or bumpers or fenders or doors or literally anything, any consumable that you would use on a drift car was available locally and relatively cheaply compared to the, you know, a 110 or a Crown or those other JDM cars. So there's a lot of reasons why it made sense. Just use the car you have. I did that. We built the whole car in like a month, took it to Final Bout, brought it back here, and then just used it as a car to drive as much as possible. Like, just try to do as many events. Ryan and I went to Drift Week 7 in this car. So we spent a lot of time in this car. I've gone down to Villains, I feel like, once a year. Yeah, had a lot of seat time in the car, and a lot of like seat time on the highway in the car. I feel like I know the car inside and out, like every bolt, every nut. I'm feeling familiar with every single component. But this car is the same as another car that I have. It's the same as the car that Gerard has. Suspension-wise, it's the same as Gerard's 110 Blit, and it's the same as my 171 Crown. So the chassis isn't so unique to the cars that we have here, and doesn't really make sense to save, in my opinion. If I had all the money in the world or all the space, I was in the middle of nowhere, or SERIALNINE was set up in the middle of nowhere, and I could just put the car outside and forget about it for a year or more and come back to it later in the future, that would make sense. But, you know, to store the car for me for a year here would probably cost me $2,500. Once you store the car for a year and a half, 2 years, it's like, well, that was the cost of getting the car fixed. So yeah, it quickly doesn't make sense to do that either. Yeah, I don't want to get rid of the car. I have like a ton of memories, but I mean, you know, I can make new memories in a new car and still have the old memories in the old car, just not have the old car. One advantage, I guess, of me crashing this car is it leaves room for a new car. I don't really know what that looks like. I really want to get a Corolla. That doesn't really help the company at all. It's fully just a emotional, ego-based decision that I want to have this car again. I could also get a FRS BRZ chassis. That sort of maybe would scratch the Corolla itch, but also does somewhat make sense for the company, as we can develop parts for that. Yeah, right now SERIALNINE is about progressing. So, you know, as you may have saw in another video, we just made all the arms for the newer next generation Lexuses. I could get one of those as a drift car. Yeah, I was looking at like 15 Crowns the other day. That's JZX 9100 platform. I was looking at 18 Crowns like I had before. I have that K-Series, which I feel like would go very well in a BRZ or FRS. I was talking about Porsches recently. I don't really know if I'm a Porsche man. I don't know if I could have a Porsche. And also it's like, I just want to go drifting. So I'm not trying to reinvent the wheel. I just want to get out there and have fun with my friends and drive with Gerard now that his car's almost done and my car is not, or my car is done. But yeah, what chassis would you like to see SERIALNINE make parts for? Would you like to see me drifting in? So yeah, lots of exciting things to be optimistic about. Thank you for being here and listening to me talk about my car. If you'd like to help support the rebirth of a new car, we have these exciting t-shirts on the website right now. I think we just sold out of the black ones of the Altezza, but we have this white one with the Altezza, and we have a black one and white one with Gerard's Aristo, which met a similar fate. Thanks for joining. Yeah, thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Thanks for being here in mourning. Thanks for coming to the roast of the Altezza.